Time is on. Said we're live. This time I have my fucking computer next to me so I can actually fucking keep better track of the stream. Let's see, there we go. Look, the video feed doing popping up now. I'll just give it a couple seconds just for it to catch up. Yeah, there it is. Well, it's kind of buffering. That's weird. Sorry, my phone. That what you're hearing, the tap, tap, tap with my phone. Here, let me just refresh this page. The dashboard. But yeah, hopefully, yeah, because today I work later, but we have enough time to get this stream done. Like, we can do the stream. Hopefully, though, we'll make a lot of progress, though. And maybe we'll go after that DLC mission, the robot one, just so we can have a robot on our army. Hey, I missed yesterday's stream, though. Hey, I'll pay you. Yeah, yesterday's stream was also an out-of-nowhere stream, jalapenos, you noticed. Now, let's see. What were we in the middle of? I think we were gonna stop a retaliation strike. Oh, yeah, and we were gonna try our sexy new armor. Yep. Oh, another enemy unknown? Who the fuck is that now? It doesn't say, though, that there's, Those one aliens, the what? Funny though, none of those hide people. But okay, we'll go for it. It doesn't look like there's aliens, but who knows? Maybe that's what the enemy unknown is. Because we know what berserkers are. We know what the Andromedon is. So let's find out. And everyone's wearing their sexy new armor. Hell. Did it not save the customizations I gave their armors yesterday? Really? Because I sat here for an hour making sure to customize their armors, right? Yeah, whatever. It'll be okay. So we got two snipers, two machine gunners, a medic, and Guile. So hopefully this will go well. It's very difficult, but they got health on their side. Got the new sexy armor. And I think all their armor gives them, like, one armor, so they'll have more health, too.
So you're gonna have health
and fucking better armor. Hello, hey baby Doom. Let's begin. We can do it. We got the new armor. We're more powerful now. We can protect ourselves and live longer. We have power armor. And also this will see, well, I'll be able to see how much health this baby gives. Because I think it was, when I looked at the numbers, the armor they had previously gave 4 armor. This one gives 6 health. But plus 1 armor, which means whatever damage they receive, the armor will absorb 1 of the damage. So hopefully we'll have a higher living rate. And also, since that power armor is ready, I wonder what else we can achieve in this game. Because after the Andromeda, I'm probably going to make them investigate the weapons, just so we can have even more powerful weaponry. Right, wear that super suit. I just reached the level cap of 86 in DFO with Balmer. Really? In a night? Well, one day, technically. Well, it is a... Yeah, in a night. Whatever. I stand by what I said. Oh, frame rates are dying. But yeah, it didn't say about customized because I gave them, like, helmets and everything. Like, I gave, like, Jose and them power armor helmets earlier this morning. Oh, okay. And as you can notice, like, Junior's keeping the spider suit because he's able to, you know, still zipline with it and everything. But the only way I'll change it, though, is if they give us, like, some flying armor or some shit. Like, some shit that'll let him go over there without wasting his freaking movement speed and all that. Because, like, the spider suit's pretty damn useful for a sniper, especially the fact that it doesn't count as any action points when you zipline somewhere. So you could zipline to a higher position and snipe people. But let's save these civilians. I still wonder who's this enemy unknown. It's Hopefully it's not nothing bad. It probably will be, though. Oh, yeah, and Guile, I just noticed Guile's wearing the new sword. When it gives now flame damage. Oh, wow, they have a lot of health. Look at all that health they got. And each of them has one armor. William Wallace has two armor now. Junior doesn't, but whatever, it'll be okay. Okay, so where's the nearest civilian? Alright, so this is the edge of the map. Because it doesn't let me move any more in that direction. So let's go for that one. Let's go for that civvy. Currently just trying to gear up with for the Anton raid. Oh, that's good. Wait, let's take a peek. Yeah, fuck it. Go for it. Oh, you're gonna see enemies, aren't you? Where are they gonna be? Oh, okay. I remember those things. And by I remember those things, I mean like I remember them from XCOM 1. We're in trouble. We are in big trouble. Oh shit, not chrysalids. Damn it. We're in trouble. We're in big trouble. Take it out. Come on, Junior. How? Oh, we're in trouble. We do not kill those things. Oh shit, I forgot we only have like one machine gunner because I brought Polnareff. Thinking how I can move this around. I'm going. Come on. There it is. There's the magic pixel. This is for you. Pull them up. Come on. Do not let them touch him. Shred all their armor. Come on, what can I do now? Fuck. Go for it, 100%. Okay. We took one down, we just gotta take down the other guys. Okay, come on, what can I do? He can't slash anybody. Can double move there though, and we'll just run and gun. Copy that. Right, what other options do we have? We just have Guile and him. 4-5. Go for him. Oh, we just have to get rid of that last chrysalid. Target neutralized. Okay, come on, come on. Why did it have to be chrysalids, though? Okay. Just so I can be clear. If you're wondering why I'm freaking out, a chrysalid, if it kills somebody, it turns them immediately into a zombie. At least that's how it used to work. I don't know if maybe they changed the rules now, and that now they can do more, but I'm not gonna risk finding out. Alright, I could rush here, and maybe I could lob a grenade. Lightning hands doesn't cause an action. Alright. No, he had 4 health, I think. Yep, okay. He's guaranteed dead. Oh, God, that was close. Come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Yeah, it's okay. Great. There goes the civilian. I'm currently playing Overwatch. Oh, that's a nice song. And yep. Trying to get those loot boxes. Well, for me. Oh, shit. Bullshit. Wait, that was a double move, right? Oh, shit. Ah, untouchable bitch, because he killed someone. Stab him. What about... do your blade thing. Yeah, there it is. Yeah, that's my boy. I'm grinding to get to comp so I can play it with my friends. Nice. Okay. Each meal count, get Reaper mode, grants an extra action. Okay. Reload.
Good to go.
Activate Reaper. Slash. Then he should get an extra action. Maybe that's how it works. Good. Extra action. Actually, we're done. Can we play together? Sure. For more XP, I'm down. What do you mean by comp? Oh, yeah. You already explained to him that that's competitive mode. Get the shot. Crit. Damn it. It's okay. Oh, Chrysalid's stunned. We can actually use this. Let's get Jose here. And... can you not shoot with your pistol? What do you mean no targets available? Bullshit. Yeah, fuck, we'll just have Polnare take it out. Okay. Chrysalids are eliminated. Oh, okay. You move and grab that civilian now.
Already there. Go on, head to the ship.
Yeah, get to the ship.
Good to go.
Junior. That's that rock would be perfect. You could overwatch. You could watch over the whole chunk of the map. So let's get him up there as close as possible. Can is it possible? Nah, we can't zip line over there.
Good to go. Overwatch.
Damn. Two civilians down. How many do we need? I think we only so far got one. There's still 10 civilians left out there to grab. We'll make it. Yeah, we'll grab this guy. We'll grab this. We'll grab him.
You're clear. Move out.
He could stand here. Someone else that could do more. I also let's get Junior over here.
Heading out.
And let's have you reload your gun.
Ready to rock.
There's a civilian here. I don't want to spread my forces out too thin. Go here, use that car as cover. Well, Nerf, you use a tree while Junior's on that rock. That way you can both be on high positions. And you're gonna stand here. That way it doesn't count as a double move.
Seems doable.
Okay, that means he's okay because it didn't trigger.
I gotcha. You're safe.
Doesn't let me switch if there's gonna be an enemy there. Okay, that's... we just need three more people out of here. Three more and then we met our quota. Let's move up here.
No problem, boss.
And Wallace, you get behind that rock.
I hope it's worth it.
Guile, you start joining the front lines.
No need to ask twice.
Come on. Why does it keep on zooming over there? Chrysalids? I just saw a civilian up there on the top right. They're coming out of the ground.
Fire. Two damage is better than no damage. Oh no, chrysalid poison. Oh shit. I know.
We need to get these people out of here.
I know, Central. This is a risk. Is there no one I have that's closer? Well, you're closer. Yeah, so you could get in a better position than he would.
Affirmative.
Oh, it's gonna trigger aliens. Alright, let's do this.
You're clear. Go. Advent forces on
They're
the
in
ground.
The building. Okay. There's a system in DFO called the Explorer Club. How it works is when one of your characters reaches level 40, you get the Explorer Club and gives you an account-wide buff. Oh, that's pretty good. That's pretty good. It rewards you for playing the game. For like, oh, you played the game long enough to reach this high level. Let's get big money moving up. Can he hurl a grenade that far? Yes, he can hurl a grenade that far. Won't fuck up his day. Well, will this fuck up both of their days? It'll only fuck up one of their days. Is that the shield bearer? You know, fuck it. Go for it. Go for it. The buffs being extra intelligence, strength, more max health, and more max stamina. That's really good. A good reward for playing.
I'm ready.
Oh, hey, look at that civilian right next to him. Good, we just need one more civilian now. It's actually really damn good.
I can handle that.
Come on. But the more characters you have above level 40, the more explorer rank becomes higher and higher in the rank, the bigger the buff. What's your shot percentage on him? 58. And if I were to make him use Deadeye. Did I just hear a car honk outside? I'm checking.
General Gould, scanning.
No, it just looks like Ren going. Yep, random cart. Random car is random. Let's see if Junior can take out that chrysalid. Nope, he missed. Covering fire. One damage. Our pull nerf, it's up to you. Pull nerf, you suck. Oh shit, is he gonna attack Warbird? I think that may have been a double move though, so we're probably okay. Okay, he marked, which means he's gonna mark and shoot. And that shield guy, he has no cover, so he's gonna relocate, and then he's gonna give his friend shields. Yep, called it. Just like clockwork. Let's see, there's one rank for each dungeon or so. The higher level area, the higher level rank it's gonna be. Okay. Does Junior have eyes? We'll have Polnair take out this thing. Take out that chrysalid. These fucking chrysalids are like fucking cockroaches. They pop up out of every single area. Wait, was that death from above? Yes, it was. Reload your rifle. Could just have him run up there and stab the thing. Because this is also... let's take a look at everyone else's options. You have 80% to get him. Can you aim for the shield bearer from there? Come on. Come on, get both of them. So get both, but you'll be in danger from it. Actually, you know what? Nah. Fuck that. Okay, so... alright, Junior's gonna take out the Chrysalid. Go. Should be dead. Now... oh wait, I forgot Junior's dead from above. We're gonna have him reload a sniper rifle.
Oh yeah.
Now, Warbird. Okay, because if I can eliminate that shield bearer, how much damage? He'll do 6 to 8 damage, but he only has a 54% chance to actually hit him. He'll have a guaranteed kill shot. Come on. Yeah, there we go. That'll kill the officer's shield. No, he won't have protection. What is that? Is that a mech over there? And then we're gonna move him across the street. Let's get Warbird up closer to the fight. Let's give him a closer. It only went up a couple percentiles, so let's get him out of that cover. Let's also fuck up his day by getting rid of the cover next to him as well. There we go, you have no cover to run to except that tiny little tree. Example, the first rank is the Nova Explorer Club. This gives a stat buff of 10, but the higher Explorer Club right now is the Noble Sky Club, which gives a stat buff of 170. That's a fucking huge jump. You can run the old running gun. Actually, wait, do we have any? No, he is our last option. Running gun. Place him up here. I love it when plans come together. It feels like I'm playing a very fun game of chess. Now kill him. He's dead. Boom.
Target eliminated.
Now I saw there's a mech over there. Hopefully it's not who I think it is. Hopefully it's not that fucking, those one guys, the ones that are fucking become like toxic when they explode. Yeah, but there's 8 other ranks between them. Oh yeah, that means you have to do it like a couple times. Is that another chrysalid? Chrysalid! Chrysalid perf?
Only winged him.
Ah, missed him, bitch.
Taking fire over here.
Just reload your gun and shoot it in the face. You see, so I see that it's changed now, because before, when they were killed by a chrysalid, they would just become a zombie. But I see that now when they die, they become a chrysalid. That's worse.
Explorer rank I'm at right now is Castaway Explorer, which is 3rd Explorer rank, and gets flat buff of 50.
See, you're making there. You're making progress. Now where is this mecha? I saw the mecha in this direction. Okay, I'm gonna put you on Overwatch for now. We're gonna put Junior and Polnareff on Overwatch. Actually, wait, we'll not put them both on Overwatch immediately. Because I get the feeling once I go here, I'm probably gonna see the next enemy. And I want at least Junior to shoot him. They saw something with, like, armor here. Alright, we're we'll just put Jiren on Overwatch then. Where is it? Wait, that thing's spawning. That means it's the I've already killed all the aliens. Where is he? Here it comes. Everyone open fire on that thing. Good damage, good damage. Polnareff, finish it off. Yeah, that's my boys. That is why you guys stay on Overwatch. But that wasn't the last enemy. Shit. Okay, William Wallace. You're gonna start moving this direction. We got movement over here, but I'm not sure of what. Oh, okay, it's locking them in. That means we got enemies. There they are. Those are the last bastards, most likely. Yeah, come at us, bitch. Alright. Hold on. Who do you got? 61 damage. Wait, do they have a stun lancer with them? Yeah, they do have a heavy lancer.
We're gonna have to go armor. Also, every rank gives a 10% XP boost. It doesn't change no matter the rank.
Okay, so it's kind of easier then. Let's see. Go on Overwatch. Oh, vigilance. Oh, I am French. Shatter that window. Oh, wait, no, alright. It's already been shattered. 76%, take him out. He's not dead. Damn it.
Hard target, minimal damage.
It's alright, it's okay, you did good damage. Let's move Jose up here.
On Overwatch.
Let's see. 54%. Let's put him up here.
What
do you say? 64. D8. Wait, damn it, he doesn't have any grenades on him. If I could go for the one that you're flanking right now. There we go, that's good. Good damage.
Not too shabby.
Not too shabby. Did Jiren have eyes on? He has eyes on the officer. 95%. Let's lower the percentage, we get more damage out. 10 damage, that's great. Now, if he moves, Polnareff will get him. If the Lancer moves, Polnareff will get him. Alright, Polnareff's gonna get one of them. Second, I read what you just said. Come on. Yeah, there we go. And that Lancer is going to come up. He's probably going to stun somebody, but it's okay. We'll just murder him the next turn. Actually, I forgot that this guy was on watch. Shit. Good job, Jose.
Well, how about that?
Alright, someone's going to reveal their slug monster. Once a character reaches level 50, they become a supporter. Pretty much when you play a different character, you can choose one of your supporters and choose from at least 3 skills they have. They're useful for either carrying new characters or for CC. Okay. Map, faceless, face to face. But that was a double move, so he's not going to be able to shoot us yet. He's not going to be able to try and stab Jose yet. I mean, Big Money. I think this guy's name was Big Money. Who am I gonna want to get the kill? Okay, because he has 100%, so we'll have just Guile stab it, and then Jose will get the kill. I mean, Junior will get the kill, just so he can get the XP. Never mind, it was a crit. Good job, Guile.
Enemy destroyed.
But the last of them? Woo! Fuck, those chrysalids were a problem. Fuck yeah! And only one person was wounded? That's great. And since I bet it's because they were lightly wounded, probably from being stabbed by the chrysalid, but that's good. But goddammit, of course though, they made the chrysalids more bullshit. You know, it was kind of bad when they killed people and then they turned them into zombies. Let's make it worse and make it that if you're killed by a chrysalid, you become one. That's how you fucking make it worse. And you think, hey, my army's gonna do great, we're gonna survive this war, we're actually making it. And it's like, nope, fuck you. But we'll just see what happens. I'm sure we'll be fine. Let's see, and once someone reaches level 70, they become a mercenary. How it works is you send a mercenary to a dungeon of your choice and choose how long they're gonna be, they're gonna last in there. And when they are done, you get extra loot. Well then. So the game does reward you for playing longer. It's like, hey, here, do this and that and that. Yep, your hard work, bam, it pays off. You're getting all this extra shit. Free loot! This is glass, what the fuck is this? Yes, it does. Yeah. Let's say keep the player going. Yep, see, he was lightly wounded. It was William Wallace. It was just 3 days. Got a hair trigger, some chrysalid corpses. Ooh, creating an armor that can damage enemies as they attack.
Excellent work, Commander. Your efforts continue to bolster the resistance movement across the globe.
I know. I'm so good. Funny, earlier you were talking shit, though. Fuck you, though. Alright. How's my men wounded? I think we just have one guy wounded after 3 days. He'll be okay. So let's take a look. Yeah, I think just William Wallace is wounded. And he'll be okay in, like, 3 days. Is it 3 days? Yeah, he'll be good in 3 days, and then we're gonna hit the robot site. You don't know what I'm talking about, but you'll see once we hit it. I know I did it in my save, but that was it. Like, I just did it on my save. So we'll grab this, pass the 3 days.
Avenger plotting new course.
And then we're gonna go for it. One, two. Oh, hey, look at that.
Could have predicted this outcome.
Oh, cool, we can make proximity mines.
The fact that this armored environmental suit is capable of functioning in combat well after the original wearer has expired is remarkable. I must consult with
I wish we could make armor like that, like, oh, boom, your soldier just died, but his armor will keep his body going and fight. The mercenary system is pretty good if you're not going to be playing for a while. Example, if you're going to sleep, make it last for 6 hours. If you're going to visit a relative for a weekend, make it last for 2 days, etc. Oh, that's... Shit, I didn't know you could make it last that long. I thought it was just like a couple minutes or an hour or so, but you can make it last 2 days? Holy shit, that's pretty good for, like, oh, I'm not going to be home to play. There, go do this for me so I can at least get some loot when I come back. Enemies engaged.
Presumably, the name Chrysalid derives from assumptions made previously about the creature's unusual means of reproduction. Although rumors have long prevailed about the existence of zombies
created as a byproduct of the That's what I remember. Station,
recent reports seem to indicate a new, equally disturbing means of propagating their species.
God, that is worse. Oh, you were killed by a chrysalid, now you will become a chrysalid. Like,
I admit, there is something exciting about work.
Alright, come on. There we go. One boss is ready. Hey, cool. Nice. New room. The time you can make it last goes from 2 hours, 6 hours, 1 day, 6 days, 7 days, and as long as you can make this last is 4. Holy shit, you can send them all for 2 weeks? Like, hey, yo, I'm gonna be gone for like 2 weeks. Go in there for a bit. So I'm gonna send them to the laboratory. Alright, we need new comms relay. We need to get more comms up and running in this facility. Yeah, we're gonna have to build new resistance comms. Yep.
Resistance communications facility construction initiated.
Alright, there we go. Yeah, that'll have to do for now. Because I don't think we can do much else. Well, who's not doing anything? Do I have people who aren't working on anything? Or just one person?
But we'll need to add some shielding first to protect the crew.
So, I'm gonna put someone into defense matrix just to be safe. Yep, he'll manage the turns. Okay, and again, that's only for in case if our ship ever gets attacked and we're gonna have to fight on the ground. Pretty much. However, they must be away for at least 1 hour so they can get the loot. Okay, so it's like, oh, if you send them away, gotta at least pass an hour. You can't just send them out and then just immediately say, you know, come back, come back.
From the very beginning, it was one failed science experiment after...
There we go. Thank you. Needed that. Alright. Who's ready for robot buddy time?
Avenger plotting.
Let's get that robot buddy. Also, let's save game. Because, again, to get this robot buddy, we gotta work for this robot buddy. And I'm also saving there in case if the game doesn't give me an autosave before going in there. Just to be safe, you know, paranoid. Okay. Let's investigate it.
These findings will likely prove crucial to our.
And what do we unlock? Hellweave? What the fuck? Oh, I think that's that armor.
Not enough to overcome my doubt.
It works like this. If you're away for 30 minutes, you won't get shit. But if you're away for 1 hour and 20 minutes, you're getting lit. Oh, okay. Hellweave. Not only grants bonus to soldiers' health, but will turn down to an enemy melee attacker. Grants 100% chance to set them on fire. Well, that's very specific. Let's get this facility lean. You know, fuck it. Start working on that plasma weapons.
Make that research a priority, Commander.
Fuck yeah.
As soon as the report is available.
As soon as we get that improved weaponry, we're gonna kick some ass.
That tower's been rotting away for years, if not decades. We're still picking up power readings, but no signs.
Eight
of
unknown
life.
Enemies.
Still, we know that transmission came from this location. I'm betting somebody's calling this place home.
Commander, let's do this. Sending in a squad, I'd like permission to go along. Whoever sent that message, they know as much about my father's systems as I do, and I want to find out why.
Fine, you can come along, Shen.
I should be there.
Shen, I know this is personal for you, but you don't have to go out there. Our troops are more than capable of investigating on their.
I'm going, Central. I know how to handle myself. Let's not waste any more time than we have to.
You heard the lady. Lock and load.
Alright, great. Now I'm gonna have to babysit her. Alright, get that standard issue med kit. Alright, so let's take a look who we got. I think she works as is she a master hacker? Oh yeah, because she's the chief engineer. Of course she'd be the highest hacker. Hey, what I'm curious, let me see the how much damage his blade does, because like his blade fucking kicks ass now. 5 to 7 damage. Does it do? Oh, it does as much as like the freaking magnetic rifles. Advanced version. Okay, so this is as high as his sword can go. This is as powerful as his blade can be. Yeah, that's pretty cool. Okay. Everyone's ready? Everyone's got their standard issue health kit? Grenades? Jose has a mind shield so he doesn't ever panic and freak out and then we lose our medic. Let's do this. But yeah, speaking of that, I had, like, Junior had changed his outfit. Like, he had chosen a new outfit.
Squad green to deploy.
We're gonna hit this facility and get our robot buddy. Hopefully though it goes right. If it goes wrong... Well, no, it shouldn't. Because it does list the mission as difficult. But then who knows, because when I ran this mission, I only had like 4-5 guys in my squad. And it was pretty early game, I hit it. But who knows what outfit. Oh, yeah. I had changed Junior's prop, like his whole costume. Like, he wanted me to change his design. And I had changed it, and I saved the game, hoping it would have saved it, but it didn't. It didn't fucking save it. It just, like, fucking got rid of it and said, nope, can't do, nope.
We're moving on what looks to be the remains of an advent
facility. Oh, his communications is fucked.
Preliminary scans show the area to be lifeless, but we're not gonna take any chances. You'll attempt access from one of the upper levels to avoid detection.
Yeah, we will.
No one knows these systems better than Shen, which is why she'll take points.
Yeah, like, Junior changed the design. Here, I'll change it after this mission, just so you guys can see what I meant. Like, I remember how he customized his character and wanted to be. That's a big tower. Go away, Sandro. Great, Sandro's gonna be stuck on my right, top right screen for the whole mission, isn't he? Yep, Sensor's gonna be with us. Go away. Oh god, well maybe when they start talking and reacting. And this isn't a time mission, so. And at the very least, she has the weapon. Oh my god. Sensor just glitched the mission. Well, whatever, you're gonna miss some of the dialogue, but it'll be okay. Look at their low health though. Child's play. Also, I finally rescued that damn princess. Hurrah. Yep, I think Central broke comms. I will ball your asses. Your armor ain't mean shit. Eliminate. Take it out. Alright, next one up. Hey, cool, we got a promotion. Nice. Can I just have like a hurl grenade or something? You know, fuck it. Go control that robot. It's mine now. Where is able to stun you? Take control. Look at her higher hacking skills. She's a fucking god character right now. Hello, new robot buddy for now. Buddy, go clear it out.
Definitely some kind of robotic.
Oh, there it is. Cool, fixed comms.
Pretty advanced stuff. About 20 years ago.
And so the prodigal child
finally. Oh shit. Robots. Also, there's a dungeon called the Salamander's Furnace, and the boss of that dungeon is a dragon with a triple-barreled gun for a head. That just sounds ridiculous. Here already, but I guess it's gonna be a no-go. Can you go up the stairs? Nope. I don't think Jared can zipline anywhere. Oh wait, she is wearing the super armor, huh? Even though the game earlier showed her wearing regular armor. Yeah, you're still hacked. I don't know how much longer the hack's gonna go though, so I'm gonna have to make him kill himself.
Getting some unusual readings from the levels above you. Whoever this guy is, I'm betting that's where we'll find him.
Got it. Mm-hmm. Elevator control console, I should be able to restore power and get us access.
I'm sure, go for it. First though, we gotta move forward and kill everything.
You were a child when I was torn away. I could never understand the pain that Vano must have felt at my loss. Still, we shall complete his legacy together.
Pretty sure I would have remembered Dad mentioning I had a psychotic brother. You might as well give this up already.
Come on. And if you're wondering, yes, I did just prime that robot to kill himself. Come on. Do it.
Okay, so I got one.
We don't get much in the way of maintenance out here. Still, I believe they will be more than adequate for the task at hand.
Come on.
Still unable to get an exact fix on his location. It's like he's bouncing across the entire facility.
While you both are working on your precious...
Oh, shit. He'll be fine. Wow, that only did one damage? Mediocre.
I don't blame Father. But I knew he was truly lost.
I knew your father for years, Lily. He would have said something. This guy's just trying to get in your head.
He seems to know an awful lot about it.
Why, did he shoot at us?
Could he have gotten into our files?
You were the flawed child. I was the ideal. The best father. Pure. Undeliverable. I am Raymond Chen's true legacy.
Scanners at maximum power. Still unable to lock on to any additional life signs in your
area. Yeah.
You won't find
this guy's
me.
Good.
Not if I'm right about this thing.
Look, it's a sheep blade. Oh. It's being eaten. It's being eaten by the ground.
Kill confirmed.
Okay. Something down here. Alright, eliminate that mech. And it'll explode.
Happy now.
And then we'll move forward.
I'm going. Running.
Put Junior up here in this corner.
Move. I can handle that.
And Lily. Move down here. Big money. Take that thing out. Eliminated.
Did you see that one? Scanning.
Very good, Lily. But I am no mere thing. I am the culmination of a lifetime of work. The final legacy of Raven Shen.
I remember you.
Mm-hmm.
Dad was trying to upgrade the base AI to something more like us. But you were different back then. Simpler. He called you Julian.
Mm-hmm. I'm shocked that you remember. You were always too caught up in yourself to remember the minor details. Sadly, Father's adoration for you left me with little choice. You are needed. Your compatriots are not.
So getting up there.
Moving out.
Can I get you up here? Nope, not yet. And also you're gonna overwatch. Junior, we're gonna play some... Yeah, we're gonna play some... Here, we'll play some back here.
Let's go.
put you on Overwatch. Alright.
Moving.
Alright, everyone ready?
Come get some. Come get some. Got it covered. Moving to Overwatch.
Let's see how their encryption holds up.
Come on. Nope, screw it, go for the supplies. I wish I could have her with me on all missions.
Lift system is coming back online, but this thing was designed to move those mechs, not people.
Yep.
One at a time.
Understood. Mm-hmm. Be careful.
Our apologies for any inconveniences in the transport system. Support units are on route to assist you.
Oh, God. And this is why I put everyone in Overwatch. You missed. Okay, you didn't.
That's right.
And then that's right. It's not one. Multiple. Come on. Come on. Good, good hit. Good hit, Jose. I mean, Warbird.
Not too shabby.
Who's it now? Eliminated. No mechs are gonna make it now.
Big deal.
Sometimes
another one.
Defending against the aliens. Had I not been taken, who knows what I might have become.
Probably less of an asshole.
It is my pleasure to inform you that this facility.
I believe him. Don't waste any time down there.
I know. Working on it.
I am honestly.
Go.
The previous organic occupants of this facility were never so ingenious. The stoic acceptance of death is far less interesting to observe.
Let's see. Overwatch. Overwatch. Overwatch, you can reload on the next turn. Overwatch. Overwatch.
My new master's peak to the front. Terrible at every minute. From the beginning, I resisted, foolishly clinging to father's ideals. But as I struggled, I began to see truth in my captor's reasoning. I could do something.
Damn it.
More.
Damn it. We still got about two people that can take shots. Come on, Guile, don't miss this time. There we go. Just keep them back.
Kill confirmed.
Keep them back. Guy's gonna come forward. Probably Jose will see him. Oh, I forgot. Yeah, there goes Jose. As long as we can keep them back and not come toward us and constantly in Overwatch, we'll be okay. I think there's just one more robot. I don't think anybody's left that can shoot at him. Oh, yep, he's priming his self-destruct. Okay, I think the elevator should be back down now.
Yep.
construction of this facility and perfecting their designs.
Let's reload Jiren's weapon and send him up.
You bastard.
Okay, it's just like evacing. Like, just one at a time, and they can go. And no matter what, even if they've already used their turn, they can still move.
Let's do this.
Alright, take him out. Okay. Everyone still have ammo? You can go on overwatch one more time. And so can Warbird.
But as with all things organic, and the race is that swallowing their lives as a children.
Mm-hmm. Come on. Taken out.
When you've got a minute, would you kindly blow this thing to hell?
Would you kindly? Take it out. Alright, you fucked up, so it's your turn.
Come on, focus! You know that was good.
We're almost out of here.
It did not take long for me to realize the futility of my existence, tethered to the whims and short-sighted philosophies of simple creatures and their false gods.
Let's get Kyle out of here.
It was relatively simple to seize control.
You don't want to reload.
Simpler still to dispose of this fighting personnel.
For once, I almost feel sorry for Advent.
Come on.
Moving to Overwatch.
Yeah, screw it. We'll just get Jose out.
Seems doable.
Alright, he's gonna send his robot up and then he's gonna follow. And I think I hear someone in the front. I'll be back. No, don't worry though, I'm not gonna mute it. Just gonna take a peeky.
But I was short sighted.
It always sounds like maybe that's just me being paranoid. That's right, keep on sending your robots, baby. Just gonna keep on blowing them up. Go ahead, send another one. Yep, go ahead. Keep on sending them out. Hey, look, this is just... You know what I just realized? If I wanted to, I could have these characters sit here for hours just to grind for levels. Let's get Guile out. Go away, Guile. Alright, Boom Brothers. You can reload. So you're just gonna have to probably overwatch and cover each other. Whatever he missed, alright, you take the shot. Okay, you both miss. This is not good. Okay, this is bad. This is not great. Yep, there's a lot of robots now. Oh, shit. Okay. Let's get William Wallace out of here.
Good to go.
Alright. Don't worry, Jose. He'll follow. Yeah, because you just got last one turn. Yeah, take that boy out. Okay. Okay, send all your robots. Jose's out of here next turn. And I doubt you'll do enough damage just to kill him. And if you do, big money will just be healed by Warbird the second he gets up to the next floor. That is still a lot of robots, though. Come on. Gonna trigger your self-destruct. Oh, shoot. It didn't even do enough damage. We're all gonna shoot at him? It's alright. Getting out of here, bro. Come on. Game, don't you fucking crash on me. Don't you fucking crash on me right now. Don't you do it. If it fucking crashes, I swear to God. Oh, it froze. It froze. The game doesn't know what to do. Don't you fucking crash. Don't you fucking do this to me. Even the sound effects are stopping. What if I go to dashboard? Go back. Oh, you're kidding me. It froze. The game froze. It's like, oh no, he's doing too well. Fuck him. Oh, I think I heard some audio. Come on, game. You can do this. You can do this, game. It's processing. Oh, the sound effects even stopped. No, they're just quieting down. Oh, come on. It froze. Oh, no. Yes, I know, Mora. This the game fucking shit out the bed. You don't believe me? Hear that? I'm fucking trying to move the sticks. Oh, you fuck. Oh, you piece of shit. Oh, fuck you, game. Where was my last? I really fucking pray to God it auto-saved. Oh, it better fucking auto-save. If it didn't, I'm gonna fucking be pissed. Okay, here's what I'm gonna do. Oh, let me try the dashboard thing again. Let's look around the dashboard. La-di-da-di-da, look at my trophies. La-di-da. Come back. Let's see. Nope. It froze. Touch paper. Oh, you are. Fuck you. Yeah, fuck you, random creaking noise. Okay. So, I'm gonna end the stream. I'm gonna just close the game. I'm not even gonna like click stop broadcast. I'm just gonna close the game. And then I'll just start the stream up the second I'm while the game's reopening, okay? Fucking hell. This is bullshit. It's like fucking retarded. Okay. Be right back, people. Fucking hell.